Hey everyone, Craig from Flying Wheels. So the other day I was at the auction, I bought this here Jeep Wrangler JKU. What the seller forgot to mention is that it pops out of first gear. So every time you're in first gear, the thing pops right out. The only way I can drive it in first gear is if I am physically holding it in first gear the whole time. Otherwise, it just pops right out. Everything I read says it's the synchros inside the transmission. I'm hoping that I can fix this by replacing the shifter. The shifter I bought, the Jeep factory shifter is over $600, and that's with my discount. Retail on it's like $800 and change on it. I did find a B&M Precision shifter, which is an upgraded shifter. I'm going to try replacing that before I go all in and replace the transmission synchros. So follow along the video. I'll show you what's going on in the truck. We're going to show you how to fix it. And hopefully by the end of the video, this actually does do the trick. And then we have a great running, smooth shifting Jeep Wrangler JKU. Hey everyone on YouTube, it's Craig from Flying Wheels. Today I'm in a Jeep Wrangler JKU. It's a 6-speed transmission, and this is what's happening every time I put it in gear. First gear, I'll leave it in, I'll start to go, and watch what happens. Pops right out of gear. I'll do it again, first gear. Pops right out of gear. One more time. Pops out of gear. Now, if I hold it while I'm driving, it'll actually stay in gear, but I have to forcefully put pressure on it while I'm in gear. So everything I read says the synchros are completely out of whack. There's a lot of play inside the gear shifter itself, inside the transmission. It from what I read, says it needs a transmission rebuild. I am not willing to do that in this car. A couple videos that I watched said your shifter boot might be in the way. This is a factory shifter boot, though. I think I've dialed it down to the shifter itself. I'm going to try, instead of replacing all the synchros, I bought this shifter online. So I bought this, what they call a BBK speed or precision shifter. That's what it looks like right here, 6-speed shifter. It was around $400. This shifter factory, like a factory 6-speed shifter from Jeep, was over $600, and that's my cost on it, and I get a pretty decent discount. So this is a, oh, I'm sorry, I said BBK, B&M. This is a B&M precision shifter. So we're gonna try to put this in, and hopefully it makes a difference. It was worth the gamble for me to try and do it, because I really don't wanna tear the transmission out and go at it. So with this, I did buy, it comes with the gasket here, and I did, from Jeep, actually buy the foam donut that insulates it and keeps the noise out and keeps all the debris out. So I bought this as well because we're going to end up needing to rip this out of the original one out to put that shifter in. So stick with the video. I'll show you how to do it, and we'll see if it works at the end. I hope it does. Fingers crossed. First thing we're going to do with the shifter, you pop it off with a screwdriver just on the top cap will pop off, and then just pull as hard as you can at this shift knob. As hard as you can, just yank it out, and it'll pull off. This is the same as the 4x4, same process. Then from there, you'll get a bolt here and on the opposite side, and then one here on the console and on the other side, and then this will start coming off as well. We are in an 08 JKU. I think I've seen videos with 2012 and newer, and the difference between the two is the center console stops here in 12 and newer versus my 08 goes all the way back. So you'll see it's all one piece, and the reason it's not coming off is because of the shifter handle. So we could get to it, we can pry this boot off, but I really want this entire center console off. So what we're gonna try to do is take the slack off the emergency brake cable and pull the handle up higher so we can remove that center console and have better access to the shifter itself. No, we're in. So we disconnected the emergency brake cable here and the center console popped right up and off. And then here you can see this rubber boot just comes right out. So that's the next step. Okay, so we have the Jeep out on the lift. We got the shifter out, the upper shifter. The Jeep is on the lift. You can see in here, the shifter itself is up there. We are going to drop the gas tank a little bit to start removing these cross members We're not removing the cross member completely. We're just dropping it down. So we're going to put a support underneath the gas tank and the transmission cross member to drop it down to give us enough space to get that foam donut out, and then the shifter. So fortunately for us, we have a lift. It's not required. You don't have to have a lift. You can do this on the ground just with some floor jacks. You can jack it up, get underneath with a creeper, and then you can drop this a little bit with the floor jacks and this cross member with the floor jacks. Now here is a hack. What I saw on the videos was that the gas tank has to come down. But when we're doing the cross members, you can actually see this front mount of the gas tank cover, cage, whatever you want to call it, is bolted to the cross member, but it's just a thin piece of metal. So once it's disconnected, once the bolts are out, this actually bends right out of the way, because this whole transmission doesn't have to come out. It's just to be dropped a little bit. So we can bend that by hand out of the way just enough to drop the transmission down so we can reach to it from up top. So you'll see now that the transmission is dropped a little bit, we have some space to play. We managed to take this donut out, this foam donut, without ripping it. Now, depending on the age and wear, this thing is going to break into pieces. So we actually did buy another one from Jeep prior to getting into this project. But it looks like we can reuse this, so this will save us $35 by returning it, and I'll reuse this. Now we're going to cut it to fit the new shifter, because the new shifter is slightly larger than the factory one. Looking at the factory shifter, you can see we just removed the bolts, four, one in each corner, and that shifter is going to pull out. So here is the factory shifter with the original donut. You can see it fits perfectly over. Going on the precision shifter, it's a little larger. So if I flip this over, you can see the size difference from here to here. So we're gonna cut this out, and I'm gonna trace the size that should be cut. Now going along the edges, if I cut it right there, I should have a perfect fit to fit right over the boot. So we know that's about the right size that should fit over. We want this circle to be the same size to fit the shifter to. So if I cut it right at here, I know that I already drew the lines, but if I cut it right about here and enlarge that circle, we should have a perfect fit. So we have the shifter in, the B&M shifter. We have the foam donut in. I just put the shifter on, the upper shifter on, just to test it out. So before I put everything back together, the transmission and everything is bolted up. It's still supported, but it's not completely intact yet. I want to test this before I put everything back together, because if it doesn't work, I'm returning this $400 part. Hopefully I don't need to. All right, so we put it in first. Wow, this is tight. Right off the bat, I can tell this B&M precision shifter is a lot tighter. And it pops. It pops in the gear a lot easier. Oh, please stay. I think we did it. It was only first gear. It would have popped out already. Try it three times. That would have been popping out as soon as I let the clutch out a little bit. I am so relieved that this fixed that problem, because I did not want to tear that transmission apart. So that is the best way to fix your first gear popping out in a Jeep Wrangler. Do me a favor, if this was at all helpful, give me a thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe for more car info, and share this video if you feel the need to. Thank you, everybody. Adios.